This is James Holder for IFL TV in association with Matt King's Gym. I'm at the Pro SW Gym today in Loughton. With me, I've got Miles Shinquin. How are you, Miles?
Hello, mate. You okay?
I'm all right. You?
Yeah, good.
Good, good. Just really want to talk to you about the news that we've heard today that you'll be fighting for the British title. Can you talk to me a little bit about that?
Yeah, great news, mate. The last, I'd say, 9 months, we've had a bit of, I'd say, bad luck, but, you know, with Dixon pulling out of the English title fight and then Ashraf sort of delaying, vacating. Things haven't gone the way we would have hoped, but you can either sit around wasting time, or we could be in a gym learning, which is what we have been. We've got some great sparring, we've been away to, you know, America, been away from Marbella. We've had some great sparring, we've had some good work, so this is coming just at the right time, really.
So with Bob Adesanya vacating, you'll now be fighting for the Lonsdale belt against Jose Burton. Was that a fight that you expected to happen?
I don't know really. I think it doesn't bother me who I fight. I just want to fight for that belt. When I turned pro, I said to Jason straight away that belts don't really bother me. You know, you can retire and have a wall full of belts. You can have a bank full of money. I know what I'd rather, but I did say to him, along that way, I do want to get a Lonsdale belt. If it's the only belt I you know, really, really want. Which sounds strange, being that, you know, it's not a world title, but it's the oldest belt in boxing, one of the most prestigious belts in boxing. So. Yeah, it's one I really want and one I'm going to get on the 27th of February.
How much do you know about Jose Burton as a fighter? Have you watched much of him?
Not loads, really. No, I think he's a bit like myself. He seems a bit, you know, untested. Neither of us have had that breakout fight where everyone can say, wow. I intend to do that on this night and I'm going to show them what I can do.
Mm-hmm. You've waited a long time for this opportunity. There was obviously talk of Tom Baker potentially, then obviously the Adesanya situation, would he fight you, would the fight happen? So you've been really patient in getting this shot and waiting to get on this
yeah,
card.
Well, Frank Warren, my promoter, he won Perth Bid to stage English title fight, which was signed and done, and then...
Against Lewis Dickinson?
No, against Travis Dickinson, who then pulled out with, I don't know, a couple of weeks beforehand. I'm not sure if he ever was going to fight, because he then retired, but, you know, it's up to him, it's gone now, it's done. Then Frank then won a purse bid for the British title fight with Adesanya. Contracts were signed by us and sent off. They didn't sign back, and, you know, I understand Adesanya didn't want to fight me because I'm a young newcomer. It's a tough fight for him. I think he'll admit it's a tough fight, and he sees his future at a higher level. I wish he'd have vacated a bit sooner so we could have got moving, but we didn't, and here we are. There's no point crying about it now. We've got our chance, we've got opportunity, and I'm going to take it.
Am I right in thinking Frank Warren and Eddie Hearn have negotiated this deal between them without it going to Perspid?
Yeah, they have. It's great. It's great for me that, you know, politics can be put aside. Frank knew I was desperate for the fight. Andy Aylin as well, Richard Clark, Jason Rowland, all worked together to push it through. You know, once it got mentioned, I begged for it to happen. To the point where no one answers the phone to me anymore. So I'm glad it can be done, and it has been done.
So you'll be on the undercard of Carl Frampton v Scott Quigg, February the 27th. Big chance for you to shine there, isn't it?
Yeah, it's a great opportunity, James. I said you before, me and Burton, neither of us have had our breakout moment yet, and what a stage to get that now. You're going to shine on a stage like this, then people are going to recognise you, and it can only be onwards from there.
Big fight. Well, listen, we'll hopefully catch you up during the camp a little bit. I really do appreciate you giving me a bit of time today, Miles. Thank you, mate.
Good man, James.
And we'll catch you again real soon.
Thanks, mate. Hang on. You turned it off? You going to turn it off? Just want to pull you up. I did tweet you yesterday, but you ignored me. Every interview I do, you refer to me looking like George Groves, alright? Now, you interviewed George Groves yesterday, and I noticed the camera was a little bit shaky, bit, you know, it's George Groves, and you didn't say look like me. What's the reason behind that?
Because his hair was quite short.
What, are you scared of George and not scared of me?
No,
is that
no,
what you're saying?
It's nothing like that.
Is it because he punches harder than me?
I'm equally scared of both of you. It's just because his hair was quite short, and I just didn't see the resemblance.
Is the camera shaking now? Like it shaked yesterday with George?
A little bit shaky.
Just want to know, because I did tweet you, you ignored it for obvious reasons.
I blocked you months ago, I don't get any of your
tweets. Muted me, yeah?
I muted you, I muted you.
I'll let you off.
Where do I get one of these jackets from?
They're alright, aren't they? Suzy Wong? Suzy Wong? Jason's short having this one, keeps telling me it's too small, but he's a cruiserweight now, I'm light heavy, so he's not having it.
If you want to send one over, I'll...
I can't, you mute me, I want to send you the details on Twitter, but you can't read it.
I'll unmute you for a jacket.
Oh, thanks, mate.
Listen, all jokes aside, nice jacket, and I'll see you soon.
Come on, James.